no joke. I'd like to buy the world a token, teach the world to sing in perfect harmony, and teach the world to snuff the fires and the liars. Hey, I know it's just a song, but it's fast for the recipe. This is a love attack. I know it out, but it's back. It's just like any fact, it retracts before impact. And just like fashion, it's a passion, sold out with it and hip. If you got the goods, they'll come and buy it just to stay in the click. So don't do that.
Now that's what I call throat flash.
Yeah.
Alright, what we did over here, we had to have that Trump soda blast. If we would strip that by hand, I'm a firm believer of stripping by hand. If we would have stripped that by hand, we wouldn't have been able to kill this rust. So we had to have that soda blast. Another thing is to get all the paint and all the old stuff out of here. So we'll go ahead and repair all this rust that we see here and get it fixed up. Now, we will be stripping the backside by hand. But the main reason we're out here is to look at this pan. Thing about that pan, co-signer.
I noticed whenever they were soda blast or the sandblasting, the steel line.
What are you
line
talking about, bud?
Brake line.
Make it clear to everybody.
The brake line rusted out. You see where there's a hole there, and there's moisture.
So the brakes wouldn't have even worked on this car if we wanted
moisture
to get it running.
Nope.
So that whole brake line's got to be replaced.
Yep.
All the way back.
Front to back.
What about them pedals? They aren't looking too good at all. You think that pedal might cut it?
Yeah.
I don't know. I bet we can get that working. But as you see, this is what happens. If you notice, this frame looks totally different than what it did when it left the shop.
Them guys at Abel's are good.
Where at?
Abel Sandblasting.
Oh yeah, Dallas, Texas.
Dallas, Texas.
So we're getting ready. What we got to do with this, since this has been sandblasted, see, if you touch it like this, right, we're going to pull this in the paint booth and we're going to put epoxy primer on it. The whole thing. Front end, rear end, the whole nine yards. And sandblasting, basically, this is what sandblasting's good for. It got all the rot off it, it got all the rust out of it, it got the gunk and the buildup of 35 years of trash.
Ready
so let's get that.
Huh? Ready for 35 more years.
Ready for 35 more. So, if my two clowns can get, oh, I'm sorry. Let me start that over. So, if my two professionals here can get this in the paint booth and up on jack stands, we might be able to get some epoxy primer on that. What do you think, Jeff?
I think it'll look good.
You see anything else we need to tell anybody about this, or is that it?
We go into the sandblasters that you need to make sure any type of mechanical parts that you're going to be using is either taped up, like they did on the bell housing.
What kind of tape are we using on that?
Duct tape. Because
that's heavy duty duct tape, though.
Yeah.
Because sandblasting won't
eat up the duct tape.
Eat up the duct tape.
But
so we'll probably blow this off before we pull it in, make sure we get all the sand off.
Yeah. There's still some buildup in there.
When we get this thing done, it's going to look like brand new.
Yep.
Now, I want to show you all one more thing, right? Jeff had a good point on this. What we're going to have to do is we will actually cut the rust off. But I think the owner said he's going to put 1963 tracks on this.
Yeah, we are going to do early tracks on this.
Oh, so we're not even going to use these, so we don't care.
Yeah, we can chunk them.
Okay, well, forget the tracks. We're going to use the early model tracks. He wants to put the early Carmen Ghia seats in. So check back with us and
SouthwestRodandCustom.com.
Hold on, dude. We're not even done yet. We got to get it in the paint booth before we tell everybody to check it back. So let's get it in the paint booth, okay? Can you guys do that?
Yeah.
Then let's get it done. All right. We had all the pieces for our motor sandblasted, brand new. If you look, it's all brand new metal. Looking good. Looking real good. I like that. There's Jeff. He's the cameraman.
Hello.
Hiding in the shadows right there. That's the guy that hides behind the camera.
And what makes it nice is that little Volkswagen stamp right there. Factory.
Where are we at here? Let me find that.
Factory.
Right. Hold on, dude. Let me get there. Now, what is that?
Factory original stamp.
I can't see it. Where are you at, dude?
In between one and two.
Okay. Oh, yeah, that stamp. All right, yeah. There it is. That's original factory Volkswagen.
Yeah.
Sheet metal.
And if you look, there's nothing, it's not rusted or cracked, where this will paint up and look better in factory with the high glossy hammer.
That's great, Jeff. Thanks for the tech tip there, bud. So we're getting ready for our hot rod engine, and everything's going to be put in epoxy primer. If we come over here, we got our frame. As soon as Jeff gets that jack out of there. Okay, we got our frame ready to paint. Now, the reason that we're going to put epoxy primer on this, this whole front end has been completely rebuilt. It's all brand new. It's out of the other car the owner had, and we're going to go ahead and go with it like that. We're also going to paint all this with epoxy black. We've already checked the transmission out. It's in good shape. There's nothing wrong with it, and it's going to be fine. We will replace the axles with his axles off his other car. But other than that, everything's going to be looking good. And we're going to be putting four-wheel disc brakes, right?
Yep.
Is that right, Jeff?
Yep, that's what the owner's talking about.
Okay, what else, bud?
Going to be picking up with the e-brake cable, or the emergency brake for the disc brakes as well.
Say that again. I don't think anybody caught. What are you talking about?
Well, there's two different style disc brake kits.
Okay, we're going to get the disc brakes that have the emergency brakes.
Right. Where you can also get the other emergency brake, but you have to put the equivalent of a line lock.
Right.
Where you hit the brake.
But we don't want that.
No.
We want to make it easy and simple. We want it easy and simple.
Yeah, the 2008 1970 model.
Okay, Jeff over here, the cameraman, he's going to paint this frame.
Using PPG supplies. DP epoxy primer. That's what we're going to use on this.
Anything else anybody got to say? Anything? Throw me a bone here. What? That's all? Time to get back to work, maybe?
Time to get back to work.
Then get your asses in gear. Let's go. Let's go see how Jeff's doing painting that. We won't be able to go inside the paint booth, but we'll be able to see if he's doing all right. See? There he is. He's spraying the motor parts now, bud.
Nice.
He's spraying all them motor parts right now.
Squeaky.
So he's using epoxy primer on that, bud. Looks like he started on the frame.
Yeah, it looks like the front end's done.
But he's not going to do the floor pans because we're going to replace those.
Yeah, that's junk anyway.
So I think he's going to be all right. He's getting all them.
All the nooks and crannies.
All right, we'll come back and check him out in a while.
Well, I was just going overviewing everything. I was discussing why we left these solid metal.
So people can actually see why we didn't do that then, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And
so what did we do? We put a couple coats of DP epoxy on it?
Yeah.
Sealed it up nice and tight?
Yeah, and I explained that we don't want any handprints. Where if I was putting my...
Well, we don't care about these though, we're replacing them.
Right, that's why we painted
that's why we
here.
Put the epoxy on it. So we're good to go then, tomorrow morning.
Looks like a brand new training.
So let's get this in place where we're going to go with it, and get her up inside and see what happens.
Yeah.
I want it right there between the car and the table. All right, that's good. All right, there you go.
Let the body in the pan say hello again.
Okay. Looks like we got a lot of work to do on that body, too. Huh?
Yeah. Rust.
A lot of rust.
The recipe, this is a love attack. I know when our body's back, it's just like any fat, it retracts before impact. And just like fashion, it's a passion for the withered and hip. If you got the goods, they'll come.